What's going on, everyone? It's another indie review.
Yeah, they're rolling in like hotcakes.
I know. I love these. It's the Indie Rundown Podcast. Anyway, man, this is what it's all about.
I love it, man.
Today, we have an independent film that we are going to review. And it's called Billboard. Zeke Zelker wrote and directed this. This movie stars Leo Fitzpatrick, who I'm a big fan of because, again, if you've seen the movie Kids in 1995, he was brilliant in it. If you've seen Bully, this guy was indie film star. He was in all these movies that I liked growing up. Pleasant surprise at the outset to see him as a disc jockey here on the station. is one of the main characters, very much so. And again, also has Heather Matarazzo. Of course, you may know her from Scream 3. You may know her also from Hostel 2 as well. She had a very gruesome death scene, to say the least.
Yeah.
Eric Roberts is in this as well. He's great in his role. John Robinson as the lead did a fantastic job as well. Enjoyed the movie. Let me give you a quick synopsis of this. According to IMDb, again, Billboard. Times are tough. Listenership is down, and Casey needs to come up with a plan to save his radio station, WTYT 960, and fast. Casey's grand plan is to host a Billboard sitting contest where four lucky contestants have the opportunity to win $960,000. $960,000 and a mobile home. All they have to do is be the last person to survive living on a billboard. So before we get into this, one of the cool things about this, if you are a independent artist, singer-songwriter, or a band, go check out WTYT960.com. This is the radio station. In the film, there is an actual website. So it has all the music from thousands of independent artists or creatives that are on here. So if you want to have your music on this radio station, go check it out. Submit to them as well. One of the things I love about Zeke is just his approach to filmmaking. This is a movie about someone trying to save, very much like Chris Farley in Tommy Boy. Obviously, this isn't straight up comedy like that is, but you know, he's trying to save while there's a brake pad company or whatever.
Good comparison.
You know, that legacy that you have to carry on and build. Very much in this case, Casey is, he's not in his element. He doesn't know anything about radio. He doesn't know anything about the business, but he's forced to find a way to keep it afloat, find a way to keep it from being defunct. You know, the Billboard sitting contest is essentially his solution to the problem. But the cool thing that Zeke does is he goes so deep in the extra mile into everything. He created, his MO is to create the world first and then create the movie. And what do I mean by that? Well, created the radio station first. So he has a website up. It's pretty much an online radio station. He did that for the movie, and it's still on and it's still going to go on. And I was joking about it with him. I was like, man, you should include this radio station and the rest of you and all the other films. You
know, kind of like a running gag. Yeah, I don't mean to say running gag like a director staple or something.
Yeah, it's something that's in his film that's live and breathing and that he can use throughout. I think it's a brilliant idea, brilliant marketing strategy too. If you want to learn how to fund or market your film, I highly suggest you go listen to our episode with Zeke Zelker, because he does an unbelievable job highlighting what it took to make Billboard. You learned so much. One of our longer interviews, but it didn't feel like it because of the wealth of information that Zeke just kept giving us golden nuggets here and there. But again, check out WTYT960.com. I thought that was a brilliant way to market his film. But now here's the kicker. There is a web series to this as well. So he had a feature film, which is this feature film in and of itself, and a web series, which if you watch the film, there are cameras that are set up to watch the contestants go through the Billboard competition. So it's so cool because it's a transmedia storytelling. But yeah, so it's two different narratives in two different forms being told intermittently. And at the center of it all is a website, WTYT960.com. Hats off to Zeke for showing us how transmedia works, because I think this is a really cool way to make a movie. I think it's a really cool way to set the tone. I think it's a really cool way to create a world to bring people in. Very effective. It's definitely unique. That's Zeke Zelker. If he's going to make a movie about someone running a bakery you better believe there's going to be donuts or muffin. You better believe there's going to be something tangible to. He's going to create. He likes to create the worlds first, and then, you know, base his film off those worlds. It takes a lot of time. It takes a lot of effort. But I'm sure he's got a lot of stuff to hang his hat on after Billboard. I enjoyed it, and I think you all will too.
Yep. To kind of go back on what you were saying earlier, I was actually opposite of you. I watched the movie after we talked to him. So I was able to kind of see where he was going first. And then I kind of knew a little bit more than I should going in. But, you know, it was kind of cool to see the radio station and stuff like that and how he built it up, you know, with this universe, basically. So watching the film, I kind of understood. It's kind of hard to explain, but it kind of helped me understand a little bit more. But
well, the way you saw the movie, it's almost like you know, it was a real radio station. It's almost not documentarian, not like a documentary, but it almost was like a reality show or like a behind the scene. Like it was real people living their lives versus a narrative film.
Right.
And this really happened. This was a contest that really happened in the 80s.
I didn't know that. Yeah, no, it's good. It's innovative, man. And like I said, I thought it was great, man. I loved it. It was a fun, enjoyable movie to watch, and I highly recommend it. And I hope it really does well. I hope it makes some noise, man. And like you said before, I really can't wait to see Zeke's next project.
Yeah, and absolutely. And Billboard, again, it's going to have a theatrical release April 5th. But we'll keep you posted on, again, theatrical release. You can check it out on Rotten Tomatoes. Hats off to Zeke Zelker.
Yeah.
Over 20 years, he's been a filmmaker. Again, according to his bio, he stays true to his commitment of making films in his hometown of Allentown, Pennsylvania. So what I really like about him is that he trains people too. He shows people. So if you're in the Pennsylvania area and you want to know a great internship into filmmaking, if you're curious about what it takes to make a film, reach out to him and see if you can apply, you know, to be on the team. And I wish he was closer too, because I wouldn't mind getting into the Zeke Zelker Film Academy either.
Me too.
He's gotten to the point now where he's able to fund his next movie off his previous ones. And as a filmmaker, that's what you want to do. All right. Well, I think we're out of here. Again, it's Zach. It's Mike. It's the Indie Rundown Podcast. Billboard. We'll keep you posted on our social media about that film. Again, at the Indie Rundown on Twitter and Instagram, like our Facebook page, the Indie Rundown Podcast. April 5th, it's coming out, theatrical release, and we'll let you know when it is available on video on demand as well. We're out.
Be sure to follow the podcast on Twitter and Instagram at the Indie Rundown, and like our Facebook page, the Indie Rundown Podcast.